Hello students, today I am going to continue with the previous video, that means numericals of dimension analysis. We have already done the four problems. Here I have written another three problems. See, first I will go for number six. Students, in dimension analysis, exponential means e to the power, exponential, or ln means logarithm. See, ln means log base e, or exponential means e to the power something. These functions, log or exponential functions, contains the pure number. It means inside logarithm, inside exponential means e to the power, there is pure number. Okay, so pure number means the constant which has no dimension. So logarithm, inside logarithm, the variables have no dimension. Okay, this is a constant value. So inside logarithm, there is the constant value, no dimension. In place of no dimension, we can write m0, l0, p0. See, so you know this a by p b, p means pressure here. Okay, in question the name of the physical quantity given, means p means pressure, here k means Boltzmann constant which is a dimension, theta means temperature, and z means length. Here z means length, capital theta means temperature, means absolute temperature, k means Boltzmann constant, which is dimension. So you know a by pv, inside logarithm ln means ln, inside ln logarithm, it has no dimension. It means you can write m0 a0 t0 means 1. So students, here we get a by b is equal to p. In some questions might ask this question, what is the dimension of A by B? Then you can write the dimension of A by B will be pressure. P means here pressure. So dimension of A by B is pressure. Dimension of pressure. Now you can put the value F by A and then put the dimension, will get the dimension of pressure. Okay. Now if they are asking for the finding constant A, the value of constant A and B, for that we can use this term az by k theta. Now students, you think, suppose you want to find out a, for that you need k. You know that theta means temperature, capital T, you need theta means temperature means Kelvin. Okay, but you don't know about k, Boltzmann constant, z means l, so you need k. For that we can use ideal gas equation. Yes student, PV is equal to KT. This is called ideal gas equation. P for pressure, V for volume, K for Boltzmann constant, T for temperature. Here written T as theta. Theta means temperature. So the dimension of K theta will be PV. So you can write in place of AZ. So AZ by PV, AZ by PV equal to ln this, means it has no dimension. It has no dimension. We can write it is equal to 1. This is equal to 1 because log of something has no dimension. If this is equal to 1, so you can write A is equal to PV by J. Now students, A equal to PV by J. Now you can put the dimension of pressure, F by A. You can put the dimension of volume, LQ. You can put the dimension of Z, means length. Then you will get the A, dimension of A. I think you can do it yourself. Okay. Now students, please pause the video and try this numericals number 5. Please try it. Do it yourself. Pause the video and try it. Okay students, see, in question number 5, here P means pressure, Z means length, R means gas constant, T means absolute temperature. try it now. P means pressure, Z means length, R means gas constant, T means absolute temperature. Now you have to find A and B. Students, you tell me, exponential of something means this, it has dimension. No, exponential of something has no dimension. Just when I told you, exponential of something has no dimension. So students, you can write A Z square by R gas constant, T means temperature, that is equal to 1. No dimension is, no, don't write 0, you will write 1. 1 means M0, L0, T0. 1 means M0, L0, T0. Anything to the power 0 means 1. Anything to the power 0 means 1. Now see, RT. Now you are responsible to find the R. R means the gas constant. But how will you find out? See, you know the real gas equation. With the help of real gas equation, we can write PV is equal to RT. Okay, PV equal to RT. Now, in place of RT, you can put PV, because in the left hand side, see, there also pressure. So we can put A by AZ squared by, in place of RT, you can put PV is equal to 1. So A will be PV by Z squared. See, student, clear? PV by Z squared. Now, if you want to find A, then you can put the dimension of PV and Z squared, then you will get the dimension of A. See, P means pressure, F by A, V means volume, L cube, Z means L squared, so you will get the A. Now, student, try to find the dimension of B. B. You tell me. A by B, then into some value. Exponential something is value. No dimension. So, A by B into some value. So, it means the dimension of A by B. Left only the dimension A by B. Then A by B must be equal to the dimension of pressure, because exponential term has no dimension. So, only we have A by B is equal to pressure. A by B is equal to pressure. A by B into something has no dimension. So, A by B has dimension. So, this must be equal to pressure. A by B must be equal to pressure. So, we can write A by B must be equal to pressure. So, A, we need B. So, B is equal to, B equal to A by pressure. Am I right? B equal to A by pressure. Now, put the dimension of A. So, put the dimension of A means PV by Z square into pressure. So, we get V by Z square. Now, we can put the dimension. Volume means L cube. Z means length square. So, it will be L. So the dimension of B will be L. So you can calculate the dimension of A and B. Pause the video and write it down in your copy. Okay, written. Now students, see question number 7. It is similar to the question number 5 and 6. See here, XT, X means length. I've written XT. Here XT means length, dimension of length. Function of time, distance is a function of time, you know that. So length, and V means here velocity. And now you need to find, sorry, this is A. Now you need to find A, dimension of A. Find the dimension of A. A is equal to what? You have to find A. So students, you try it yourself. Okay, so students, in next video, I will discuss some more numericals regarding dimension analysis. Okay, so thank you students. Keep watching and keep doing. Okay, thank you.